Dear friends, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. It's me, your teacher, Dr. Jeffrey. In the name of God Almighty, today we have to talk on the causes for the invasion of Mahmud Ghazni to India. As we told in the last lecture, Mahmud Ghazni invaded India by different causes or reasons. The same, the emergence and development of the Turkoman tribe based on Ghazni and Ghori. Later they want to conquer or they want to control the territory of India with many reasons. As per the historical records and the opinion of the historians, the causes for the invasion of India by Mahmud of Ghazni divided in this manner. Majority of the historians' opinion that Mahmud wanted to establish the Ghori of Islam by destroying the image of the Hindu gods and spreading Islam. One of the major opinion on the conquest of India by Mahmud of Ghazni is he wanted to spread the message of holy faith to the ideals. Worshippers, among the ideal worshippers, or he wanted to establish the Islamic Empire in India. There are many critical opinions from the historians is there. Anyway, one of the opinion was he wanted to establish the glory of Islam. And the second opinion is Mahmud wanted to loot the wealth of India, for he loved wealth. As we told in our first lecture, India is a country of trade, or the trade emporium from the ancient to medieval period. Of course, the Middle East people are always attracted the wealth of India, and they want to accumulate or acquire the wealth by conquering the land. The same feeling of Mahmud led him to invade the country. And the third opinion is Mahmud wanted wealth, and also he wanted to meet the cost of his army and the expense of the warfare, and for he wanted the expansion of his empire. He told that one of the motives behind his Indian expedition is that he wanted to become a great conqueror in the world. So for that purpose, he engaged many battles during his sultanate period. To manage these expenses, Mahmud wanted more financial support from the other sources. When he conquered or he wanted to invade India and get the wealth from the land. So here we discuss the main third point in two reasons. One, he wanted to maintain his army and wanted to expand his empire. To manage the expense of the battle, he collected money from the Indian invasion. And the fourth opinion is that Mahmud wanted to satisfy his ego as one of the greatest conqueror of the world. As a Turkoman Ghazi warrior, Mahmud had his own tribal feeling. He wanted to become a superior commander and the superior king or the empire in the world. He wanted to be known as the greatest conqueror of the world. For this purpose, he wanted to get more money. Then he invaded to India. For the religious reason, Mahmud plundered India is recorded by some of the historians. Mainly he looted the temple wealth or the rich wealth of the temples and trade centers of India like Sistan, Multan, etc. Mahmud also fought with the rulers of Ghor to establish his supremacy in Afghanistan. That's why some historian claimed that Mahmud is not a religious fanatic, because he attacked the Muslim rulers of Ghori parts of Afghanistan, or the Ghori rulers faced the same fate by Mahmud of Ghazni. Here some of the opinion about the historians which related to the reasons which we told above. What is the causes for the invasion of Mahmud of Ghazni? One of the reasons behind this advancement is greed for the wealth. The reputed historian Havel has rightly remarked, Mahmud would have sacked Baghdad, an important place of Muslims, or the center of the Abbasid Caliph, with a little conjunction as he plundered Somnath if the undertaking has seemed as profitable. Havel is comparing these two attacks by Mahmud of Ghazni. Mahmud attacked Baghdad, the center of the Abbasid Caliphs. The same feeling or the same manner he attacked temple of Somnath. There is no religious motives. He want to get the profit from these invasions. So what? He invaded India. There is no religious motive on behind of the attack on Indian temples. Another opinion from Professor Habib is of the view that Mahmud wanted to getting the wealth of India was the real motive behind the invasions, and also some other motives behind the invasion of Mahmud of Ghazni were subsidiary. It's not mainly main motive of the invasion of Mahmud is the accumulation of the wealth or acquiring the profit from these invasions. According to Habib, it was not unusual that, like the Catholic Church of Europe, The Hindu temples attacked powerful invaders to loot the wealth contained therein. Mahmud, of course, is a Muslim ruler, but his religious feeling didn't lead him to attack any Hindu temples, because during the Crusadic period, many European churches were attacked by the Muslims because of the wealth which contained these institutions. The same manner, Mahmud of Ghazni attacked the temples of India. It's not only for the religious feeling, but also the wealth of the country. The contemporary historians like Utbi reported that Mahmud are of the view that for his chief objective was to spread the message of Islam in India and to break the ideals of non-believers. Mahmud's invasion have been termed as jihad or crusade to spread Islam in India. One of the most referred work on Indian medieval Indian history is the record of Utbi, or written document of Utbi, mainly used by the criticizers of the medieval Muslim ruler. Utbi is mentioned that Mahmud's main motive to convert the Indians to the beliefs, convert to as a believers, for this purpose he led some jihad against the country. Anyway, it's not 100% correct, because he want to conquer India by its financial popularity. And also they argued that the wealth being the only objective, Mahmud would not have broken ideals. He forced non-Muslims to embrace Islam. This is a very important point. In his whole attack to the temples, Mahmud would not have broken any ideals or any temples, and he would not force any non-Muslims to embrace Islam. He attack and collect the wealth, then return to Ghazni. Dear friends, historians like Habib, Khalik, Ahmad Nizami and Zafar vehemently disapproved of this objective of Mahmud of Ghazni, or this type of opinion. They argued that there is no principle of Islamic law which supports the act of temple destruction or encourages them. Islam is always a religion of symbiosis, a religion of peace. That's why this act of Mahmud is not supported by the teaching of Islam. That's why he only a materialistic. He had some material interest on the Indian wealth, not for the spiritual perspective. Anyway, all these views does not hold ground when it is seen in the context of his 17 successful victories. On the opinion of Lernpool, one of the famous medieval Indian historian, a record, Mahmud did not aim at permanent conquest in India. Time had not yet come when Turk could think seriously living in India. He wanted to attack and acquire the wealth, then went to his own capital city. Now, this is some of the discussion about the causes and the motive behind the conquest of India or invasion of India by this Turkoman Ghaznavid ruler. Anyway, mainly it is said that, like all ambitious rulers, Mahmud wanted to have name and fame by his conquest. He wanted to become a great conqueror in the world. For that fame, he regularly interlude the politics of India. Another type of scholars' opinion that one subject of Mahmud was acquisition of skilled artisans from India, as he was very fond of constructing beautiful buildings in his capital city. Mahmud wanted to bring the skilled persons or skilled artisans or skilled men from India to Ghazni and want to build or construct many buildings in his own capital city. Mahmud wanted to Ghazni is one of the greatest city in the world. For that purpose he attacked India. Anyway, all these reasons, whatever the reasons which described by the historians in many verses, according to all these records, Mahmud invaded India. After he appointed local vassal kings to rule in his name in many of the conquered regions, then it easing the relations with non-Muslim population. By this association, he get the support of the local people, and also he welcomed many Hindu and Ismaili soldiers and officers into his army. After conquering this area, Mahmud recognized these people and he appointed these soldiers as his own men. However, as the cost of constant expansion and warfare began to strain the Ghaznavid treasury in the later years of his reign, Mahmud ordered his troops to charge at Hindu temples and strip them of vast quantities of gold. Two reasons behind the expansion industry of Mahmud is that, first one, he want to beautify his capital city. Then for this purpose he wanted wealth or finance or economical growth, and also his continuous warfare affect the treasury of Ghazni, and he wanted to find out some other source to collect the money. For this purpose he attacked the Indian temples, the most famous centers of the wealth during that period. Difference, of course, Mahmud was attracted to the enormous wealth of India. These wealth made him repeatedly raid India. There are some religious dimension to his invasions of India, and he attacked the temples of Somnath, Kangra, Mathura and Jwalamukhi to earn the nickname of the idol breaker. There is some other opinion is that. Anyway, all these points describing the motive of Mahmud Ghazni to attack the Indian territory. To sum up the above opinions, it may be said that there were several reasons for Mahmud's invasion over India. Unanimously, all the historians agrees that the wealth was certainly an important reason for his invasions. Regarding his religious opinion differ. All the historians are agreed the main reason behind the expansionist policies of Mahmud is that to accumulate the wealth of India, or he attracted the wealth of India. And there are many opinions about his religious concern on the Indian attack. Dear friends, the further involvement of Mahmud of Ghazni will discuss in the next class. Hope all are understood or will understand these reasons behind the Mahmud of Ghazni to conquer the land of temples. Hope you are enjoying and prepare your note. Thank you for your patience. Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.